Thank you, everyone. Thank you for those kind remarks. Welcome, principals, teachers, parents, students, to this Zero Carbon building. I'm very excited to see many young faces here. Congratulate yourselves, please. The future is better than you think. Please let me tell you why. More and more people, even those from less resourceful parts of the world, will have access to education, clean air and water, more rewarding and less hazardous jobs. Taking care of the Mother Earth will not stand in the way of economic development, because saving the environment is economic growth. Not long from now, the world will not be flat. It will be fluid. Power brokers in old hierarchies will have to give way to young innovators. Our grandchildren will live in a society where everything is possible. How do we get there? You may now be wondering. First, we need technologies that change the way we work and the way we live. Believe it or not, thanks to all the great works done by innovators, engineers, scientists, and designers, a lot of these technologies are already here. Do you see the ceiling fans up here? They are no ordinary fans. They're painted at high speeds, move large volumes of air at low speed. The fans cool the room down while consuming much less energy. Room cooling here is also aided by earth-cooling tubes, which harness the natural coolness of the ground under Earth, us. This building is powered by renewable energy sources. As you may notice, the giant solar panels installed on the roof generated electricity for use. Zero Carbon building even boasts a native urban woodland, all grown from homegrown plants from Hong Kong. And other landscape areas, including a vertical garden wall. We are proud to call this building Zero Carbon Building, short form ZCB. Hong Kong's first Zero Carbon building, and I can tell you, it's really the first, because I was in London last week, and everyone was talking about Hong Kong's first Zero Carbon building. As it was designed to leave no carbon footprints. You may join the guided tours of the Zero Carbon building to check out some of the amazing things today's technology can do here. But technology and innovation alone are not enough to take us to a better future. We need wider adoption of these designs and technologies. We need to be aware of our impact on the environment. We need to promote and live a culture of sustainability. And that is exactly the reason why our partners, the Standard, and my team at the Construction Industry Council want you to come here. We are all very proud of your achievements in writing about current events, the latest technologies, the society we live in. Essay writing is a deep engagement with our intellect and compassion. I think it is an excellent practice to think through a problem and see what can be done. Many of you tackle globalization in your essays. You point out the problems that plague the world today. I am particularly heartened by your willingness to be challenged and your capacity to think about what we can all do. I quote one of you, what you have said. As a global community, it is time to take action. You start with small steps. Take sustainability, for instance. I encourage you to explore the place. Tell your family and friends about your experience today. Zero Carbon building is only the starting point of your journey. And what you can do with the knowledge and writing skills you have learned in liberal studies lessons is entirely up to you. At home, you may reflect on this day and think about what you can do later. Volunteer for a green cause. Find your passion that changes the world. Do something and help one another. After taking to many of the award-winning students today, I am very hopeful that the future is not only better than I think. It's really going to be magnificent. Now, on behalf of the Construction Industry Council and also the Standard, I want to congratulate our students today for a job well done. And also thank our principals, teachers, parents, for the efforts in nurturing these great minds, which Hong Kong really needs. Today, with this short speech, it is my pleasure to inspire students to make a difference in our world. Please, every effort counts. If I run into any of our winners again sometime today, I hope it will be my turn to get inspired and to celebrate the difference you have made. So, ladies and gentlemen, students, everyone here, we must do something to our world and make it more sustainable. So on this note, I would like to thank the Standard for giving us an opportunity to promote not just my company, but also to promote our future well-being of our society. For this, I thank the Standard and Mr. Tom for his efforts in terms of actually doing these little studies. And on this final note, I'd like to thank all of you, because with your help,